sister Ruthie, and all of our brothers and sisters, a lot of them are gathered in here. And the whole staff is coming in from all over the ministry to wish you a happy birthday. They're pouring in from the lobby right now. And the PTL singers have another song to sing for you right now, right?
Right.
All right. This is for you. Right now, and see what we've got planned to say happy birthday for Tammy Faye today in the studio. Look up at your monitors right now.
Congratulations, Mr. McGowley. It's a girl.
We left to go to the hospital at 1 o'clock a.m. When we got out there, we had a severe snowstorm that day, and the snow was up to the running boards on the car, but we made it okay. We left home at 1 o'clock. Tammy was born at 27 minutes after 3 a.m.
Tammy was the shortest little person I ever saw, but she was so cute that just took over, and she wasn't wearing those high heels, so that made her really look short.
Well, Jim and Tammy came in from Minneapolis, and I thought she was the cutest little thing, and we loved her right away.
First of all, I remember when we first met her, I remember she had this pretty red dress that Jim thought she looked so cute in her red dress.
I remember it, and oh man, back in the 60s, I believe, you and Jim wanted to get married. You came to our house quite often, and we asked you to babysit. And I was really impressed with you and always thought you were really cute.
Yeah. It's like I worried about you marrying me for my money. Which I didn't have.
You didn't even have a bath. I mean, a bathroom. They only had a path.
We had the outside, the path instead of the bath, as Jim called it. And he was scared to death of the rats. He thought there were rats in that outside privy. You know? So he was afraid of that. And I guess he put his butt in one tub and his feet in the other. He thought that was the way he was supposed to take a bath.
You know, honey, some of the most fun times that we ever had
was on the Jim and Tammy children's programs.
Absolutely. Hilarious.
Yes. And then there was another time that things really got out of hand about soap.
Oh, no. You're not going to tell on that.
No, I'm going to let them see it.
I got to tell you.
I'm Columbus, Georgia.
This is the hint for the mothers. This is the hint for mothers. When you buy soap, like say you buy 4 and 5 bars of soap at a time, when you get home, if you'll unwrap the soap and leave it out of its wrapper and just leave it out, you know it'll last a lot longer. That's the truth, because it dries out, all the moisture gets out of the soap, and that soap will last you twice as long when you take a bath. You mothers will love me for that hint.
I didn't know that.
That's the truth.
How come you don't unwrap bars?
Jim! I just learned about it.
Reading,
well, that's a good hint, though. I heard that.
Okay.
Good hint. And it makes your clothes smell good if you like to put it in your drawers. Dear Jim and Tammy Sue. I mean,
read the letter.
To be her daughter.
Spice of life. That's what it's like being Tammy Baker's secretary.
You too can make this beautiful piano. Oh, Terry, I think it looks great. If everyone was just like me, the whole world would be dingy. There you are. And here's our fudge. Ouch! Sniff.
And, well, they won't. As long as they don't bite.
Sometimes talking to the boss, sometimes absurd. All of her a kid and all of her a lady. A strutting the gym or playing with the babies. It's Tammy, a double whammy, a bubbling Christian love. I said Tammy, a double whammy of turned on Christian love. Sharing her Christian love.
What memories, huh?
Yeah. Yeah.
All right, and it wouldn't be a birthday party without, let's listen. Who's this?
Mom, we skipped school just to say happy birthday.
Oh, it's Tammy Sue and Jamie Charles. Come on out. Hi, kids. Come close to Dad and Mom.
Tammy Sue Baker.
Oh. Don't you think this hasn't been a hard secret for those two kids to keep, haven't they, huh? Oh.
Hey,
and Tammy, listen. I found something several months ago and bought it especially for you today. And there it is.
Oh, Henry.
Soap.
Yeah. And it says 40 and sexy.
Oh! You know, all this week is Tammy's birthday week.
Oh,
and there's going to be even a surprise in the sky when Tammy walks out of here today.
Oh, don't say it.
And we want to thank Whammy Radio for declaring this weekend Tammy Faye weekend. Oh. And they're featuring her songs all week long. And manager Jim Bell is here with us to say happy birthday from Whammy Radio. I want you to listen to this voice who wants to wish you happy birthday.
Tammy, remember when we crowded into the pastor's car and there were so many of us that you had to sit on the floorboards all the way to Lake Geneva?
You haven't seen her in 20 years, Ada D-Rod.
Come on!
You haven't seen her in 20 years.
No, I didn't know her. I recognize her hair. Just look. We both gained just a little bit of weight, Ada.
You were just best of friends.
We really were. Oh, man. We used to lay out after we got home from work, remember, Ada, and try to get suntans. It was too late, but we tried, didn't we?
Well, somebody else came to say happy birthday. Listen to this voice.
Tammy, remember those Sunday afternoon dinners at the Rex Cafe?
You remember? Nancy?
Nancy Boyum!
Nancy Boyum! She hasn't seen Nancy in 20 years!
All the time in our home church.
I'm giving their, they have new names now. They're both married. So it's Nancy, Boyum, Helen. And so she, but I have to, if I used her new last name, Tammy wouldn't have recognized it probably.
No,
how long has it been? Almost 20 years.
Oh, my.
It's 17.
Yeah.
Isn't that something?
I'll tell you why I said Nancy's so little, because she used to be much heavier.
That's what happened.
And she's so little.
Did you sang together?
Yeah.
And I put my first mascara on in my whole life at Ada's house. And
oh, she's the reason.
She is. And she...
There it is, folks. It comes out.
And Ada kept saying, Tammy put a little bit more on. It looks good.
We went to a yard sale and bought a bag for 10 cents.
Yes.
Remember?
And we came home in front of me. The first time I ever put eye mascara on my life.
You can talk after the program. Is this the trio that won the camp award?
Yep.
Is it really?
Yep.
We're missing our red dresses, though.
Yes. What's the
matter? Oh, no. You had red. And you won the camp. Tammy was queen of the camp, do you remember? And you girls won the best.
Lake Geneva Bible Camp.
Yeah. Did you have a lot of competition in that contest?
You bet.
Yeah, sure.
It was tough competition in those days.
Well, Tammy, the girls have been rehearsing that same number that won 23 years ago.
Oh, no.
The camp singing contest. And they've rehearsed a little bit. You haven't. We got it on cue cards. We want you to, Ron can go to piano, and we want you to sing the song just the way you sang it 25 years ago. Come on. We got to hurry. Come on. Go over to the piano. We got microphones. Come on. This is the song they haven't sung it. And where are you all going? This piano. Help! Over here. There's three microphones for you there. We've got it all planned. Now, it's a medley of just a little talk with Jesus, and just do it like you did before. You rehearsed it 25 years ago. You don't need to rehearse anymore.
I don't believe this. Testing. That was higher than I used to sing it, girls. Okay, let's try it again, Ron, one more time. I once was lost in sin. You sure I sang lead, girls?
Yeah. I once was lost in sin. But Jesus took me in, and just a little light from heaven filled my soul. He paid my heart in love and wrote my name above. And just a little talk with Jesus makes it hard. Now let us have a little talk with Jesus. Let us tell him all about our troubles. He will hear your pain and cry. And he will answer by and by. Now when you feel a little prayer will turn it, and you'll know a little fire is burning. You will find a little talk with Jesus makes it right. I may have doubts and fears, my eyes get filled with tears, but Jesus is a friend who watches day and night. I go to him in prayer. He knows my every
That's enough. Cut, cut.
I think I sung three keys higher than those.
Come on back, girls. Come on, girl. Wasn't that great? 25 years later, the 20th after camp. And I want you to know you girls are still winners. All right. Here's somebody else that's come to say happy birthday.
Tammy, remember that special day when I told you about Jim Bakker?
Peggy.
No.
Peggy? Okay, no. Go.
Janet?
Janet Schoberg.
Yes.
Is it Janet Schoberg?
Yes.
You're kidding
Janet
me.
Schoberg. And Janet Schoberg and now Janet Schoberg Mathis. Since you've seen her.
Oh, man, she left for school. Her and I spent, how many nights? We spent every weekend at, before you left for school at your house. Mm-hmm. And then when you left for school, we went to Ada's. I went to Ada's house. I was the younger than Janet. And you went to school, what, 2 years before I
a
did?
A year before.
A year before mm-hmm. me, I did, yeah. Right. And Janet, I remember when Janet learned to drive. She'd come by my house and pick me up. Your mother would fix that seven-layer dinner. Mm-hmm. We'd right. sit around the piano with your dad and sing all the time.
Right. Aww.
And she married a preacher, too, at Bible school, didn't you?
Marvin.
Yeah.
He's not in the ministry.
You both found husbands at North Central right. Bible College.
Mm-hmm. How many right? kids do you have?
Two boys.
Two boys.
Right.
Oh. Nancy, how many kids do you have?
Three boys.
Ada?
I have four. A daughter and two boys.
You got four boys?
No. Oh. Well,
there's somebody else here to say happy birthday, too.
Tammy, I'll never forget that wedding reception Mama had at our house for you and Jim when you came home at Christmas. Tamara.
You haven't seen her? That's Phyllis. That's Phyllis LaValle Tanner now. You haven't seen her in 20 years.
Each other. And she sent me some sample of the ashes when the thing exploded.
Okay. Mount St. Helens.
I got your book, Jim.
She lives in Washington State.
No,
is that
Oregon?
Well, that's where Mount St. Helens is, right? I don't know where anything is right now.
I don't believe it. We hadn't seen each other in years and years and years, and she went to a bookstore, and she saw my book, I Gotta Be Me, and that's the first time she even guessed thought of me in years.
I called you.
You called me and told me about it, and she said, Tammy, I know. She said, I laughed when I saw you were blonde.
There's
Her
been many
like
a change
mine, you know?
In the last 20-some years. We want you to...
Oh.
Someone else has come to say happy
dear.
Birthday to you, Tammy.
I think I'm going to have a heart attack or something. Oh, man.
Listen.
Tammy, do you remember a trip to Chattanooga when Jim was driving and got us lost on these winding mountain dirt roads? I was 3 months expecting, but you got sicker than I did in the back seat.
That's Brenda Hill. Dale and Brenda. Our original directors of the Jim and Tammy show, his director, started when he was 16 years old, our dear friends for 17 years now. You remember when Tammy Sue was born, don't you remember on the Jim and Tammy show set and all?
Right, right. Really brought back memories to see that bit, you know, the tape for you.
Oh.
Really brought back a lot of memories.
Oh.
You were really blonde then.
I couldn't believe I was 4 inches taller because my hair was piled up.
Oh.
That's right.
Oh, what moments we had. You remember when the little girl wet her pants on the show, on the Jim and Tammy show, and she kept saying, it was the first time I ever heard positive teaching, you know, on power of positive speaking. She was sitting in this big puddle in this beautiful little frilly dress, and she's saying, I didn't wet my pants. I didn't wet my pants.
when you were asking your chief engineer's little boy what he was asking the children what their parents told them not to say, and he says, "My daddy told me not to cuss."
Well, here's someone else to say happy birthday today, Tammy.
Oh. Hi, Tam. I never thought I'd ever have a friend as small as myself.
That's our neighbor and one of Tammy's best friends, Judy Bycura. Mrs. Dr. Blair Bycura. Hello, Judy.
You know what it does to me.
I know you and Tammy.
Don't be nervous. You're okay.
What did you think when Tammy Faye moved next door to you?
I was thrilled. I had prayed for a friend for 5 years, and I never thought I'd get the cream of the crop.
Judy.
We love each other.
We really do. We shop on weekends,
and we cry together, yeah, and we laugh together.
We sure do. God put us next to just the perfect family that God wanted us to be in our new house, Jim, and I'm so thankful for Judy and Blair and their children.
I want you to listen to these next people. They love you so very much, and I count them as two of our dearest friends that have been so kind to us over the years and really has said to us so many times, you can make it. So listen to this birthday greeting.
Tammy, behind every successful man, there is a successful woman pushing. So here we are, honey, just you and me.
That's Maude Aimee and Rex Humbard.
You can believe it, but more than that.
Oh, that's so wonderful.
When I heard, I said, we're going to celebrate two things today. We've been married 40 years.
Oh!
And you've been born 40 years. So we're celebrating. How about that? And when I started, Maude Aimee and I have one very special thing that hangs on my wall. 50 years I've been on radio. 30 years I've been on TV, and all of it for God. And nobody has ever understood God's people. Jesus, our leader, was misunderstood. They finally drove nails in his hands and in his feet. So when we started, I reached up on the wall in my office, and I took down my favorite picture and Maude Aimee's favorite picture. And we brought it to you today, and I want you to see it. It's old Daniel in the lion's den. And first of all, Daniel's standing here, and he's looking up. I look unto the hills from which cometh my help, the Lord God of Israel that never falls asleep.
Oh, amen.
And these lions, I've often heard people say they didn't have any teeth, but I believe they did.
I think so, too.
But you know what? God did one of two things. God either took their appetite away or lock their jaws. And so, Tammy, I want you to know, as I look at that picture and I see Daniel, I think about these many, many years of toiling, and then I name this the SEC. That's the first line.
I love it.
Then I name this other line our local newspaper. I won't call their name and give them any advertisement at all. And I went right on down the line, and there's seven of those lions in there. And they all represent something that wants to destroy God's child. But I have news for you.
Praise the Lord.
Daniel said, I live forever.
Yes.
And Jim, so I want you to do two things. When the going gets rough, I want you to look at this picture and remember the God of Daniel is your God. Second thing I want you to do is I want you to look at your hands, and you don't have any nail prints yet, so you're getting off lighter, lighter than our leader.
Oh, amen.
And could we do one thing, Jim? Can I do anything I want to do, Jim?
You can do anything you want. I'm in days.
All right. I want everybody here to stand, and I want Tammy to stand, and I want everybody at home to stand, and we're all going to stretch our hand toward her today, and our birthday present to her is going to be our prayers, and we're going to will you everything good God's got. Okay?
Praise God.
Stretch your hand toward her. Father, we bless Tammy, also this ministry that you have entrusted into Jim and Tammy's hands and their staff. But we will her everything good the Father has from his bountiful table, all of the joy and the happiness and the peace, but more than that, the assurance, the faith, the strength, and the courage that we need to carry on the work. We thank you, Lord, that you are taking care of the lions. And we thank you today that you're with us, and we bless her and will her everything good from the Father's table, for our God shall supply all our need. Thank you, Lord, for blessing her. Amen and amen.
Amen.
Happy birthday.
Maude Aimee and Rex Humbard were in the midst of producing their own television program. And when they heard it was Tammy's birthday, they said, we will cancel things, move them around, because we're coming to Tammy's birthday party and surprise her today. And
you'll never know how much that means to me, Jim.
And Tammy, that fog opened up only about a few seconds.
Our plane was late, Jim, and had our plane not been late, we couldn't have landed. But the plane was late, and the airport opened back up, and there we landed.
And then you know what they said at the airport? The minute they landed, it closed back up again.
That's right.
It only opened a few minutes.
Oh,
and
I always
landed.
Said he could part the waters.
Don't mind, Amy and Rex look fantastic.
Yes.
Man, you look so
Tammy,
good.
Tammy, when you get 60,
younger.
Honey, if you look this good, we're just
man.
I just want to say one thing. You and I better stick with them. I'll tell you why. The President of the United States spoke the other day in Washington. I was in the same auditorium. Maude Aimee, be still. I was in the same auditorium. But you were coming the next day, and you were not there. Yeah. Take care of Jim.
Yeah.
And I wasn't close to take care of her.
Yeah.
So they got to talking, and in a little bit, the people up on the podium stood up. Well, they thought the audience stood up. And the two of them stood, and there's 3,000 people out here, and they're the only ones standing. Can you believe that? So we're running around taking care of them. You take care of him, I'll take care of her.
We got out of
there,
didn't we, Jim?
Oh, we got out of there. Oh, it was embarrassing.
I said, Jim, let's split real quick.
Yeah, here's a microphone.
Oh, Tammy. My goodness, please don't do that while I'm singing. It'll scare me. I might pass out.
Because of the balloons popping.
There's a little song that I love to sing. Sort of just fits you and it fits me. So I'm not going to look at you when I sing it because I'll cry. And I wish you'd quit crying on these programs because I just sit home and cry 3 hours a day. But it's when my way groweth drear. Precious Lord, linger near when my life is almost gone. Hear my cry, hear my call, hold my hand, lest I fall. Take my hand, precious Lord, and lead us on. Precious Lord, take our hand, lead us on, help us to stand. Sometimes we get weak and worn, but through the storm that's for you.
Nobody can sing it like Maude.
Tammy, greetings are pouring in from all over. Here's a special card with lips.
Oh, isn't that cute?
This is from all the students in the college.
Oh,
and they've all... Here is, this is today's edition of the Heritage Herald.
Oh, beautiful.
And Judy Bycura and her husband took a whole page ad, and here's what it says. This is our neighbors. It says, the Bible says, love your neighbor, and we do. Happy birthday, Tammy. Love, Blair, Judy, Darren, and Ryan.
Thank you, Judy, Blair.
Well, and... A lot of your friends went together. You have not read today's Charlotte Observer, but they do print some good news contrary to popular belief. This is what some of your friends have done. Since you haven't read the paper yet, you'll read it later today.
Precious.
Hundreds of your friends went together and bought an entire page of the newspaper. The staff members, and to say happy birthday, Tammy Faye. And
I'll say that forever.
I want you to have some birthday cards. And so I helped all of our partners with a little surprise for you. And here's some birthday cards from the people that love you, our PTL partners. Bring in those birthday cards for Tammy Faye from you that are watching doing. On them, so you can take these home in the baskets and read them. Say happy birthday, Tammy. Literally thousands of our partners and friends. Sent you a birthday card, and they've all written you messages of love like I've never seen before. I have to keep going. The hour, it's only an hour. They love you, honey. There's some more people that want to say happy birthday.
Hi, Tammy. Do you remember when we used to go to the bakery and get Bismarck?
Did you?
And then we'd come back to the apartment.
Her aunt, who's helped raise her, and she's never been here, has never once come to our ministry. Tammy loves her dearly, and Aunt Tootie as well.
Aunt Jim would ever be here because she's got claustrophobia and won't fly. Did you bring her?
I drove
her. This is my brother John. So. This is Aunt Tootie. We used to go out to her farm and spend so much time.
John drove Aunt Jim here.
Thank you,
Aunt Toot circled the airport this morning. She was supposed to be in last night. She's been in that air an hour and 15 minutes, fogged above Charlotte, and the fog just lifted a few minutes ago, and she just landed minutes ago, just got here.
Praise the Lord, we got here.
I want to tell you, I was so nervous. I said, oh, Lord, we worked so hard to keep this secret, and the last minute, three of our guests were still up in the air over Charlotte. And I said, call the airport, tell them to let those planes circle a little bit longer. And I went out over the door and I said, fog, leave! And they're here. Praise God.
Oh, man. What, how do you like it?
I don't think they've seen it yet.
They've never seen PTL. They've never seen the studio. They've never seen anything of it. I never thought they would. It's so nice. Oh, goodness.
does Aunt June mean so much to you, Tammy Faye?
Oh, goodness. Next to Mama, she raised me. You know, Mama had eight kids. There was eight of us, you know, and Mama was so busy all the time. And I took my baths over to Aunt Jen's house because she had a bathtub and I didn't. And I slept through overnight, and she made me my clothes. And I mean, everything.
Fixed your hair.
Fixed my hair. And she'd say to me, she wouldn't even let me holler ouch when she gave me a permit. She'd say, Tamara Faye, it takes pains to be beautiful, and if you don't want to suffer a little bit, I'm going to quit right now. And boy, would I shut up. I could imagine myself right in the middle of a perm and her quitting on me.
Angie, what was that baked goods about you were talking about?
Bismarck.
Oh,
we used to go down to Schultz's Bakery a couple blocks away, and then we'd get those Bismarcks, oh, you know, they've got frosting on them,
and filled with all
jelly.
That good stuff.
Then we'd come back to my apartment, and we'd sit there and drink it with sweet pop.
That's right.
It's terrible. But the Bismarcks were so good.
Do you remember when Tammy came to work for you at Woolworths?
Oh, yeah.
This is my million-dollar baby from the Woolworths store. Aunt Jen was at the Woolworths store, how many years? 44 years. And I always say she really managed the store, but she was the power behind the manager. She was assistant manager, bookkeeper, and
Jen,
she ran the store, really.
She used to always make me get, I had to get there a couple minutes earlier than everyone else because she'd say, now, Tammy, you've got to be an example to everybody else, and there was no excuses.
I always expected more from Tammy than anybody else because she was on my niche, you know. But I can remember her, she'd come after school, and she'd be dressed in her school clothes, and she'd have on these tight things around the waist and these great big full skirts with about three slips underneath them. And there she was out there trying to get around the counters and wrap packages and bring the registers and everything else. And one time she came in there one night and she had this big full skirt on and then just a little sweater casually hung over her shoulders, you know. And I could see that that wasn't going to work, bringing registers and wrapping packages, those that sweater hanging there. So I gets up and goes out of that office. I says, you either take it off or put it on, one or the other.
What about?
She's after me all the time.
She tried the candy counter for a while, didn't she, at first?
No, they wouldn't let me work there because I was too short and couldn't see over.
Yeah, that's the story. Tammy is 4'10", and they couldn't see her behind the candy counter because those shelves go up high, and all they could see is this little hair bobbing above the candy counter.
It's a good thing, though, because I don't think nobody realized how much I like candy.
The funny part was, though, Jim, when she would, I was going to help her manage her money, you know, because I knew she had such weaknesses. And especially for purses. And then so she thought, well, I'll just go around, I'll charge it here and there, and generally Aunt Jen will never know, but I knew all the time she was doing that.
Did you do that?
Well.
Well, now it's...
Oh, dear. Right. Mother, did you know about this?
right now, Tammy, I hate to do this, but you're supposed to sing.
Oh, come on.
And I introduced a song at the beginning of the program, and it's a brand new song. She's never sung it before on television. And it's really one of the great songs. I don't know what I did with that record. Is it over there? It's on this.
Maude Aimee keeps track of it.
And
there.
You can make it record. And it's Mercy Rewrote My Life. Do you think you can sing it?
I'll sure try.
Okay, then we'll come back and share a moment. This was the song we introduced almost an hour ago. And what a time we had keeping this from Tammy Faye. I want to tell you, what a time. And we kept her rehearsing so she wouldn't go back in the dressing room and find all these people right up to the last minute of air. In fact, they kept making mistakes on the song. She didn't know it, but we were doing it on purpose. So she had to keep rehearsing it so she wouldn't go backstage and find everybody. She's always saying, you all people do that to me. But here's a song that is really Tammy's theme song. Mercy Rewrote My Life. Tammy?
Song. Then crew
She just recorded on the new record, You Can Make It. Tammy, come on quickly, honey. Our time's gone. If you'd like to have a copy of this new record that Tammy just sang, if you'd like to send a gift of $25, we've got 3 weeks to save our satellite. I can't understand. I live from crisis to crisis. I'd like to have Rex and Maude Aimee come and share with us someday some of their stories. They've got to come back. And the stories of your heart attack and all of the miracles God's brought you through. They ministered to me at dinner a few weeks ago. It's really, I'm living on that little time together with them.
You can make it.
You can make it. And I want you to have this. If you'd like to send a special gift, we'll send them out right as soon as they're off the press in the next few days. And some have said they're going to send $40 in honor of Tammy's birthday. We can't figure out what 40 means, but you know what it means. And so if you'd like to do that and be a part of this birthday celebration, and say, we want to help PTL. The best present you could give Tammy is to help take some of this financial pressure off from us and pay our bills, isn't that right?
So he can sleep at night.
But if you'd like to have this, and You Can Make It songs on there, and you ought to play this on your record player every morning when you get up. You can make it, because you can make it. We just got word that another radio station in Charlotte, WHVN, has declared this is Tammy Faye Week, and they're featuring you all week long.
Thank you, radio station.
Well, Tam, I don't usually let you have the last word, but if you'd like to have the last word, happy birthday. I love you.
I love you too, baby, and thank you. And I love you, PTL partners, and I love you, PTL employees. I love you, family. I love you, Maude Aimee and Rex. Thank you for coming. I love you, Hayden, Nancy, and Brenda, and Dale, and Judy, and Janet. I don't even believe it all. It's just too good to be true, Jim. I thought 40 was going to be real awful, but I'm beginning to think it might be the beginning
life
of
begins
the
40.
That's life yet.
Tammy, for so long, I said, she just has dreaded her 40th birthday. And she just kept saying, oh, I'm going to be 40. I'm over the hill. And I purposed in my heart, I said, Lord, help me to give her a birthday party she'll never forget. And I figured out the friends and the people she'd like to have near her and surprise her. And they all came. And they all helped me. They the friends paid for ads in the newspapers. This is all of this and all these cards. And all, this is an expression of love from thousands of people,
Tammy. It's the best birthday I've ever had in my whole life. Thank you, Mom, for having me.
We love you so very much. Tammy and I love you. And friends are the dearest thing we can have besides Jesus. I've often said if I could give somebody the best present in the world, I'd give them a friend, a good, true friend. And we're so thankful for friends that love us when we've made mistakes, love us when we're not perfect. God's love is the love that loves us when we're weak, when we're strong, when we're right, and when we're wrong. God's love is consistent and eternal. And I want to tell you people something. God loves you. He never forgets you. And you talk about a reunion. This has been a real reunion. This is like people Tammy hadn't seen in 20-some years. Just think of what heaven's going to be. And my prayer for you is that not one watching this program will miss heaven. You think this is exciting with this family gathered around us here. What a day it's going to be when we see Jesus face to face. All the pain will be gone, the disappointments and the heartache. If you don't know Jesus Christ as your Savior, call on Him today. And you can be born again. You can have another birthday.
Most important.
You can be born again through Jesus' blood and say, Jesus, come into my heart. Forgive me of my sins. I want to be a part of the family of God. Take time to write us. And if you want to write a little note to Tammy and have this new record, do it today. We love you so much. God loves you. He really does. Bye-bye for today. Happy birthday.
Thank you.
Friends, the news is out. You can make it. This entire album of songs written by Mike Murdoch and sung by Tammy Faye can be yours simply by writing and sending a gift today. $25 is what we're asking, but you know something? The news is also out that this is Tammy's 40th birthday, so maybe you'd like to send $40 as a special happy birthday gift to Tammy. Won't you write today and ask for Tammy Sings, You Can Make It. Help us to save our satellite network by sending your gift today to Jim Baker, Charlotte, North Carolina, 28279. In Canada, that address is Jim Baker, Box 140, Station U, Toronto, Ontario, M8Z5M4. But don't put it off, because we have just a matter of less than 3 weeks in order to pay off the arrears on the PTL satellite network. So you write today, send your gift, and say happy birthday, Tammy, and keep the satellite on the air. Praise the Lord. Praise the Lord.